And we're back. Hey guys, what's up? Alex here. And in this video, we are gonna do some exciting stuff. Okay? Not really. We're just gonna set up any hardware that you might have. I know, okay? It's boring, it's lame, it's menial, tedious even, but it's gotta be done. It's instrumental. And we're gonna get into recording a track together soon. I promise it's gonna get creative in the next few videos, and we'll get there. We just gotta lay the groundwork first, okay? All right, so sit tight and let's get started. Okay, so you might want to record some audio in Bitwig. A big surprise, I know. You could probably do all right just working off of samples, but eventually you're going to want to input some of your own flavor into Bitwig, okay? Whether it's recording MIDI, recording through microphones, guitars, basses, whatever you got, electronic drum kit, doesn't matter. It's all in the same principle, okay? And so if you were to go ahead and click Command Comma, it brings up your settings. Alternatively, you can click the Bitwig sign, which is your dashboard. It'll bring you there. Go over to settings and then down to audio. Okay, so here is where we're going to kind of set up our interface. And if you don't know what an interface is, well, it's the middleman between your computer and anything you want to record. For example, a microphone, guitar, bass. And the reason you need this middleman is because, well, first of all, where on my computer exactly am I going to plug in a guitar? I know some of you are probably thinking, well, I have a microphone input on my computer. Yeah, that's cool and can be handy for doing, you know, and you know what? I've never used it, so I don't know why you would use it. But it can't record guitar. Even if you got an adapter that brought it from the quarter inch down to the 3.5 millimeter jack, it's not going to work, okay? You need a middleman. And another reason is because an interface will have preamps in it and they will have a sound to them. They'll sound much better than if you just have a raw signal going into however else you would get into your computer. I'm not even sure, okay? So here is basically asking you, what device do you want to use right now to record and output the audio? And right now it's set into my built-in microphone and my built-in output, and that's for good reason. So my input device, when I'm recording and I'm actually using Bitwig and I'm not just making these videos, I'm never going to use this microphone. Okay, this microphone that's built into your computer, that's for like Skype and FaceTime and stuff like that, okay? And it's not going to do much for you as far as recording. I mean, I shouldn't say that. Music is pretty fluid. You can do whatever you want. But in my case, I have an interface, and so I'll click this drop-down menu, and then there you see it, the Scarlett 2i2 USB. And that's because my interface is a Focusrite Scarlett. It's got two inputs and two outputs. When it says two inputs, it's kind of actually four because it's two guitar inputs mixed with two microphone inputs, but you can only run two at a time, if that makes any sense to you. It's a pretty great little interface. It's pretty sexy looking. It does everything I need it to. Good quality, good preamps in it, and they're not too expensive. Actually, you can get a decent interface if you're starting out for well under $300. Just go to Amazon, check that out. Okay, so I'm using the Scarlett right now to record my voice, so I'm not going to click this because I don't want to create a conflict in my computer because a different program is using this to record my voice, okay? Any other time, I would click that. And if I'm clicking this as my input, then for sure, I'm going to click that as my output, okay? You don't want to plug your headphones into your computer and then your guitar or microphone or whatever into your interface, okay? Your computer's brain has to split in order to figure that out. And it's gonna create latency and it's gonna do all kinds of weird stuff. You want the same device or the same interface that's converting your analog signal to digital to also be converting the digital signal to analog, okay? That's important. And it's all about latency. And what is latency? Well, we're gonna get into that right here because that's important. Now, if I'm playing guitar to a tempo, which I hopefully would always be playing to a metronome or a click track. If I'm listening while I play through headphones, I'm hearing that click right away, okay? But when I strum a chord on my guitar, by the time it weasels its way all the way through my gear, through my interface and into my computer, there's going to be a little bit of delay. And it even tells you right here, you're going to have 5.8 milliseconds of delay. It looks like an accurate number, but it's approximate, okay? And where that's a problem is it might sound fine when I'm recording, but then if I go and play it back, it'll sound like I suck at guitar because it'll be super late, super behind the beat, okay? And you'll notice the further I drag this slider this way, the larger that number gets. But there's a use for doing that. So if I'm recording an instrument, guitar, vocals, bass, whatever, I'm going to bring this as far to the left as I can, as few samples and as little milliseconds as possible. The thing is, the temptation is to go to 32. Well, unless you have like a mammoth of a computer, 32 is going to create clicks and pops in your sound, okay? And that's not good. It's going to be taxing your computer super hard because you're basically telling your computer, I want you to dedicate all of your resources to getting my signal into this DAW fast, 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 okay? And 32, that is stupid fast. Look at that, 0.73 milliseconds. No way a human brain is picking up 0.73 milliseconds. But also, very few computers are going to do this. I'm yet to work on one. And so I set mine around 128. I have a pretty decent Mac, and 128 gives me 2.9 milliseconds of delay. Not bad, not really noticeable. And it's just enough that I'm not getting any clicks or pops. My audio quality is not suffering and my computer is working decently hard, but again, not hard enough that it's interrupting my audio. Okay, if I'm done recording and I don't plan to do anything more live, all the way to the right, because there's no need for you to worry about the milliseconds anymore. You're not recording live. You're not monitoring a guitar or a keyboard or a vocal anymore. 2048 samples. Give your computer all the space it needs and all the time it needs to process your plugins and your audio and do everything that you want it to do, okay? And that's just a general rule of thumb. We can get super technical on this. For now, just recognize if you're recording, go as far to the left as you can. It might take a little experimentation to see where, you know, the sweet spot is. Mine is 128, yours might be 256, or you might even get away with 64, depending on your computer and your CPU. If you're done recording and you're just going to work on your track with headphones, all the way to the right, okay? All right, so that's very important. It's so frustrating when you're first starting out and you feel like you nailed the part when you were playing it and you listen back and it sounds like total garbage. Yeah, that's why. Okay, and it's the same for MIDI. Okay, people don't realize that it's the exact same for MIDI. If I plug in a MIDI controller and I hit a key and there's a delay, that's why. So down here, it's basically asking, what are the input buses? And so, in other words, how many inputs, it knows how many inputs are on my interface, but how do I want to assign them? I'm going to go ahead and delete that. So right now, I have a stereo input. I have actually two inputs on this device, and it's saying, okay, well, input one is your left, and input two is your right channel, or your left speaker and your right speaker. So if I plug something into both of these channels at the same time, I'm getting that stereo sound. But if I plug in a guitar, it's only going to be in one channel, right? And that's going to be a mono channel. So if I do this right now, and I plug it into input one and record it, I'm only going to hear it on the left side, and that's frustrating. Right? Like, that's weird. What if you just nailed the part and all of a sudden it's only on the left-hand side? Then you got to deal with that. You got to like sum it to mono and all this crap. Forget about it. Okay. Click add mono. All right. And then it's asking it. So, okay. You have a mono input. What input is it? And I'm choosing one. Well, it's kind of chosen for me. I could choose two, but I'm choosing one. And I'll even label this guitar. Oh, that's not how you spell it. Guitar. So now when I plug my guitar into channel one, it's a mono input, and you're gonna hear it in both speakers, okay? Because a guitar is not a stereo device. It's only a mono device, and that's how I want to record it. I can add another mono and maybe call it microphone. All right, and maybe I want that on number two, okay? This down here, the output buses, depending on your interface, you might have to play with this. In general, you're good as you are. Like, it'll sort its stuff out. Usually, it'll make it so that your outputs are already assigned. You got your headphone mix on it, and don't worry about it, okay? Unless you're going heavy. If you have like a crazy interface of some kind, got a whole ton of outputs, and you want to assign them to all different places, then you need to worry about that. And really, it's not that big of a deal. It's the same as this. You're just going to add sources, add a stereo, whatever, okay? I don't need to do that. I only have two outputs. Oops, I wanted a stereo, not a mono, okay? All right, so now that I've labeled these guitar and microphone and stereo input, exit that. If I go to an audio file or an audio track, sorry, right here, you'll notice that this panel changes. Remember, this is your dynamic info panel, and it changes to accommodate. So now it's asking, what's the source of the audio I'm going to record, and where is it going to? And right here, if I click on the drop down menu, you'll see the two things I made, guitar and microphone. And I know, because I made it, that that's the mono, that's input one on my interface, and it's mono. All right, I could record guitar and stereo, but again, it'll just be on the left side, and that's dumb. So where this is handy would be if you're plugging in a keyboard, for example. And so then you would use up two inputs, depending on your keyboard, and you would get a stereo signal. But don't worry about that. Just for now, just recognize that what I did inside the settings, it created it here for me. Okay, this is the input from other tracks. So if I want to record off of this track, whatever this track plays or outputs, I want it to record on here. Well, that's easy. I just click clean organ and post or pre, you'll notice. Okay, post just means it's after this channel volume fader. All right, and pre is before that. We'll get into that later when we start getting creative with recording. But for now, just realize that's your inputs. And this is your outputs. I want it to go to master, and I'm right now I do. Maybe I want it to go to an effect, or maybe I want it to go to another channel, but I'm not gonna worry about that. I'm just recording it, and I want it to go to master. Okay, here's your volume, and that's your record enable. I shouldn't have even said that. We'll get into that later. We're just setting up your hardware right now. Okay, command comma again, or click this. And we're back here. If you have a MIDI keyboard, click controllers, MIDI controller, MIDI keyboard, same shit, okay? And you can detect your controller. Now, the thing with that is Bitwig is new, so it's all the main, like, newer, like, really, really popular MIDI controllers that are here. And I have an Alesis VI25, great little keyboard, but it's not on this list. And so, don't worry. And see, no Alesis. Don't worry about that. It's still going to work. Add a controller manually and click generic. But in my case, I actually didn't even have to do that. As soon as I plugged it in, it brought this sucker up, and then I selected VI25 out, and I'm good. That's it. The keyboard works. Everything works on it. I have no issues with it. If you don't have this, you need to click add controller manually, generic, and then it'll kind of try to assume what kind of keyboard you have. Like, I do have 8 device knobs, and it is also a keyboard. Or you can just click MIDI keyboard if you have like one of those little cheapo M-Audio jobs, okay? And so here it's asking, where is it receiving the signal from? Well, obviously from the output of my MIDI controller. And if you ever plan to send MIDI data from Bitwig to a controller, say the controller that you have is a fancy one and it's got great sounds on it, and you want to use those sounds, well, then it'll show up here and you can click down and choose the input of that controller. I don't have that option here because my controller doesn't have sounds on it. It doesn't even have the option, okay? But if that's a plan for you and that's something you want to pursue, it'll show up there. You simply click it and you're good to go, all right? So lastly, the thing I want to stress out on you the most is this right here. Don't get frustrated with delay. Don't go and email Bitwig and complain about their software. I mean, you can if you want. I think it's pretty great. I don't have any issues. But just realize that if you're getting delay, it's probably somewhere in there. Okay? So I know that was super tedious and super boring, but it was necessary. I hope you took away something from that. And we are going to get into creating a track soon, okay? I promise. I can't wait. I'm so sick of going through and making lessons for all the boring crap. And I know you're sick of watching it too, but it's necessary. We want to streamline your workflow so that when you do start making music, you go off with a bang. Okay? All right. So, okay. Stay sexy, folks. We'll see you in the next video. All right. Bye.